Good morning, children. In class 8, you have read about India's struggle for freedom. The last phase of independence after the Quit India Resolution passed by the Indian National Congress in 1942 brought many political developments in India. The Second World War broke the economy of Britain. The Congress won all the journal seats in the post-war elections to the legislature, and Muslim League won the seats reserved for Muslims. Looking at the situation, Clement Attlee, the Prime Minister of Britain, decided to transfer the power to the Indians as soon as he could. The first attempt in this regard was, the Cabinet Mission Plan was sent in 1946. Under this plan, a Constituent Assembly was to be set up to frame a constitution for a free and federal India. Now the question that comes to our mind, what has independence to do with constitution and constitution with independence? How will Constituent Assembly frame a constitution for India? So let's try to answer these questions. Children, how do we play games? How do we live at home, in society, and so on, and as well as in school? The answer is simple. According to rules and regulations. We even follow rules and regulation at school. Again, why rules and regulations? Very simple. To maintain discipline. No injustice is done. Everything is done in a fair manner. To stay peacefully and happily. Children, in the same way, every country is governed by a set of rules and regulations. This book of rules and regulation is called Constitution. Today, we will study about our Constitution and its salient features. What is meant by Constitution? The Constitution is that body of rules and laws according to which a state is governed. Children, here, state means country. To understand the definition, the Constitution defines and determines the form of government, the powers to be exercised by the three organs of the government, the legislature, the executive, and the judiciary. Limitations on the powers of the organs, people's rights and duties. Our constitution is known as the fundamental law of the land because it is superior to the ordinary laws enacted by the parliament or state legislatures. A law that violates any provision of constitution shall be void. Void means it has no value or authority. Our constitution was enacted and adopted on 26th November 1949. The Constitution came into force on January 26, 1950. Now children, when our Constitution was ready on 26th November 1949, why was it enforced on January 26, 1950? January 26th has its historical importance. The Congress session at Lahore on December 29, 1929 had passed a resolution declaring Poorn Swaraj, complete independence, as India's goal. It was decided that 26th of January will be observed all over India as a Poorn Swaraj Day. So the first Complete Independence Day was celebrated on January 26, 1930, till we got our independence on 15th August 1947. So, in order to mark honor to the date, the Constitution came into force on January 26, 1950. Salient features of the Constitution. 1. Universal Adult Franchise. Our constitution is based on the principle of universal adult franchise. It means that all citizens of India who are 18 years and above of age have the right to vote, provided not otherwise disqualified. Second, single citizenship. The Indian Constitution recognizes a single citizenship. Every Indian is a citizen of India and has the same rights of citizenship, no matter in which state he resides. Fundamental rights. The Constitution guarantees us with 6 fundamental rights which are justiciable. Children, justiciable means the right to move to the courts on the violation of the fundamental rights. There are 6 categories of fundamental rights: right to equality, right to freedom, right against exploitation, right to freedom of religion, cultural and educational rights, right to constitutional remedies. Fourth, fundamental duties. The fundamental duties were added to the Constitution by the 42nd Amendment Act 1976 as a new chapter, Part 4A. There are several fundamental duties, but the most important are: 1. Duty to uphold and protect the unity and integrity of India. 2. Duty to safeguard public property. 5. Director principles of state policy. Director principles of state policy are mentioned in Part 4 of Constitution and are non-justiciable. Director principles act like the directions or guidelines for the policy makers at center and state government while making laws. Thus, the director principles of state policy are intended to create a social order in which justice of every kind shall prevail. The state should ensure that the citizen have adequate means of livelihood. 2, the economic system does not result in the concentration of wealth. 6, a welfare state. The Constitution of India lays down that state shall strive to promote the welfare of the people. Under Part 4 of the Constitution, which includes the directive principles of state policy, the state is directed to ensure to the people 1. Employment, 2. Education, 3. Assistance in cases of old age, sickness, and disablements. Thus, a welfare state is a country which provides a wide range of social services to its citizens. So children, in this lecture, we have studied about meaning of the Constitution, adoption, enactment, and enforcement of the Constitution, salient features of Constitution such as universal adult franchise, single citizenship, fundamental rights, fundamental duties, directive principles of state policy, and a welfare state. Thank you, children, and stay blessed.